A dance can say 1,000 words.
Pretty excited, huh?
I'm really excited.
What do you want to do first?
Go out for dinner.
I'm just excited to leave my LGA and just see family and friends.
Certainly,
shopping.
The countdown is on for New South Wales to reopen. After 15 weeks in lockdown, here's the question everyone wants answered.
Premier, is this the last day we'll spend in lockdown?
Well, that's certainly the intention of this government.
In a pre-recorded message, the PM also dangled the promise that only targeted restrictions may be enforced.
New South Wales will begin a new chapter. It will open up safely as part of our national plan and stay safely open.
But it's a step, not a dive into freedom.
Our indoor pools will be opening from tomorrow. Our gyms open from tomorrow and you can book for classes up to 20 people.
Restaurants, retailers, hairdressers and pubs are also welcoming customers inside for the first time in months.
While most businesses are thrilled about opening up, it's not all roses and butterflies. There's a lot of pressure and responsibility that comes with it. And that includes ensuring everybody is double vaccinated.
Marty Lynch says while his staff are mostly happy, some are worried about coming back to work.
From that sort of initial anger, safety perspective, and also people trying to do a bit of a cheeky and sneak through the doors without being vaccinated, and from a health COVID safe perspective as well.
The opposition says policing vaccines is an unfair burden on businesses.
Very late for the vaccine passport. It should have been unveiled for Monday. It should be in operation across New South Wales tomorrow.
Instead, a pilot of the vaccine passport will be trialled in parts of regional New South Wales. In the meantime,
you can get a paper certificate from Services Australia. Secondly, you can get a digital certificate in your Medicare Express Plus app. Thirdly, you can also get a digital certificate in your wallet, be it a Google wallet or an Apple wallet.
There's a warning from both sides about abuse towards service workers.
No one will believe that you're a hero if you abuse a 15-year-old girl working in a retail supermarket.
So I just ask, treat everybody like they're your neighbour's daughter or son.
Cases and hospitalisations are declining. Case numbers overnight dropped to 477. Hospitalisations and ICU are also down. Tragically, another 6 lives lost, taking the total this year to 431. These numbers are expected to rise more steadily as all restrictions are wound back by December 1. Antoinette Latouf for 10 News First.